In this chapter, we're going to add spatial mapping to our application to let our app reason about the world around the user. Specifically, we're going to let the user place the origami collection by picking it up with a gesture, looking around the room at their real-world tables and surfaces, and then tapping again to place that object. Minimize Visual Studio. And then back in Unity, we're going to add the spatial mapping asset to our scene. This is going to provide the mesh to our application so we can explore it. Go ahead and drag the spatial mapping asset into the root of the scene, and then make sure it's selected. Over on the right, check the box that says Draw Visual Meshes. Also, next to Draw Material, click the little selector circle. In the search box, type wireframe, and then click the wireframe material. And that's actually all you have to do to see spatial mapping mesh in your world. Go ahead, File, Build Settings, and Build and Deploy as usual to just see the spatial mapping mesh. You can work with spatial mapping in the emulator using a virtual room. You can choose this room in the emulator settings. So now you've seen the spatial mapping mesh in the world. Let's take that and make it useful by letting the user gaze, tap to pick up their object, look over here, and then tap to place it again. Minimize Visual Studio again. And now create a script. I'm going to call this script tap to place parent. We're going to apply this script to the stage object, so expand the origami collection, and drag the script onto the stage object. This script will let the user place the origami collection when they tap on the stage. Go ahead and double-click on the Tap to Place script and paste in the code from this chapter. The onSelect method here will be called when the user actually taps on the stage. Whenever they tap on the stage, we're going to toggle whether the stage is in placing mode. If we are in placing mode, we're going to draw the mesh around the user so they can visualize where the HoloLens understands their environment. Then, every frame, if we're in placing mode, we're going to move the stage around. We're going to do this using array cast, just like we did before.
However, this time, we want our ray to hit only the real world and not our holograms. We'll do this using the physics ray cast mask here.
We're going to take the position of the ray cast and make that the place where we put the stage, and then we're going to rotate the stage so that it faces the user. Make sure you've saved. Go ahead and minimize. And then build and deploy your app as usual.
Now when you tap on the paper, you'll be able to move the origami collection around the world. As you look around, you'll see it hug the surface of the spatial mapping mesh. Tap again to place it.
You've now learned all the key components to building a holographic application. You've learned how to place holograms at real-world locations all around you. You've learned how to take those holograms and add interactivity to them using gaze, gesture, and voice commands. You've learned how to take spatial sound and add it to your holograms so you can hear them as well as see them. And finally, you learned about spatial mapping to let your app reason about the real world around you. Now that you've learned all that, we're excited to see what you can build.